Welcome everybody, you're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we're focusing on the Trade Ogre API without using an API key. The other version we'll do in a future video will be someone who actually set up a user account who sells, buys, trades different coins or crypto, for example. This is a pretty straightforward API. We're going to make four different calls, manipulate the data, and throw it into a data frame, which will be used in a project in a future video, such as Pandas T8 or something like that. Feel free to hit me up here on my socials. All the code will be in the link in the description below, and I gotta do a shameless plug. Feel free to help support the channel with either a super thanks, consider a membership, or possibly go to buy me a coffee. Sorry, but I gotta do it. Here's the documentation for this API. Since we're not going into the private API, you could just call this right here directly with the GET request. It's fairly easy, and you're going to have some kind of output like this for one of these coins. For this are four simple imports with pandas, request, JSON, and datetime. You're just throwing in this simple base URL, which we're not even having to manipulate, and we're doing a GET request to actually pull and extract the data, and we're converting it into JSON. I printed off the first three entries so you can see what's really going on. You can see the same thing if you look at the API documentation. We have some coin with an initial price. We have some kind of price, a high price, a low price, a volume, a bid, and an ask. That's the first bit of data that we're going to play with. If you directly throw this into a data frame, you have some issues, because if you look at the column names, you say, well, I have all of these coins. Okay, this looks pretty good, but why is my data going diagonally in a dictionary or a JSON formatting? What's really going on here? Okay, but think about this. You have your first entry in the first row, first column, second entry in the second row, second column. So you could kind of see what's going on, right? You have five rows, but you have 139 columns. So you say, oh my God, all this junk is NaN values. How do I fix this? What's going on with these data that we're just pulling? If I'm pulling this first entry from that data that we had above and I transpose that data frame, now you have our first coin with all the data, which looks like it's parsed out properly. But what is this right here? Why isn't there a column name? Because this now is actually your index. It is not a column. So if you're doing a table view, this would be perfectly fine because you'd be able to see what this is, or if you did a nested table. That's not exactly what we're trying to deal with, right? So this thing about how we can start parsing this out. We can take our coin, which is an actual key, and we can look at the values, which is this list of dictionaries, and that's what we're dealing with. So if we iterate through this instead, what we can do is go through line by line, which is taking this for I in range length and placing this within a list. So what I'm doing is I'm taking all of my list of dictionaries and I'm putting that into a new list and I'm extending it, so you're not creating more nested lists that you have to iterate through. And then I'm storing all of the keys and I throw the pure data into a data frame. So when we look at that data frame, we're going to see something. What about the tickers? Now we have this column of tickers that we want to have, right? And we're going to have that as our first position for our data frame for simplicity's sake and for reading the data. So we insert that new column in. If we use this one right here, it throws in the new column. But if you uncheck this and run this one, you get an error because this already occurred first. That's why I have this blanked out. So now we have all of our tickers, and you could get rid of parentheses if you need. But needless to say, that's our first example that we parsed, so we're good to go. The second example is if we're doing an order based on some kind of particular coin, some kind of crypto. So that's what we're going to do next. We're going to run our GET request, and I'm going to store the information using a default dictionary, which allows us to take our values and store them as a list. So you have one key with all of the matching values stored in a list. So what I'm doing is I'm taking this GET request and storing all of the key value pairs from the JSON as an actual tuple, where you can take the key, which is the position zero in the tuple, and the value is the number one. And I'm saying if the key does not equal success, because that's something that you're going to see here. Let me print that off for you so you actually see what's going on, and we'll go step by step. You see this? This is what I'm trying to get rid of, because that was just from our GET request and that's useless. So we're saying if this success is not there, let's create a default dictionary where we're going to take our key and append the value, and we're doing a list comprehension where we're iterating through our values, which are going to be called items stored as a tuple. Then we're going to store everything in our data frame. And you say, oh my gosh, what's going on here? Now I got a buy sell. I have two separate columns, and then those are tuples. And what's really going on with those tuples? If you read the documentation, you're going to see what's going on. Now let's think about what we're doing. We have these two columns that we have to parse, which are these tuples, which kind of look goofy. But if you read the documentation, it'll make sense, and I'll explain as we go through this. I created this function where I need this name of columns list, which would be something like this. like buy and sell. And then I'm chucking in whatever data frame, which in this case is this guy. And I'm iterating through that list. There's a problem here. This would normally be just fine, but I'm going to explain after I do the printout and show you why this is a problem. When you're using JSON or Pandas Explode, you're doing two different things. Today, we're not doing JSON breaking open dictionaries, but we are flattening out lists. When you flatten out a list, you're making your data longer. You're creating more rows, and you're also having your index position repeated based on entries which are the same, like such as a key or something like that, or if it's based on like the same information for that particular row, like got expanded. Here, I'm creating my new column names where I'm taking a price per dollar and the quantity. The first entry in the tuple is price per dollar, and this is the quantity of whatever coin they purchased at that time. And I took that data frame, and when I iterate through the column names, I'm converting everything to a list, and then I'm changing the index now. And what we're printing out is now our price per dollar and quantity. So let's look at each one of these and see what's up. So here's your price per dollar for buy, and you have 151 rows. But let's pay attention. You have 137 rows. If we were to do this function here with this bracket with buy and sell together, you're going to get an error because you have mismatching rows. And if you want to account for that, you need to do an exception or some kind of rule that's going to account for this while you're doing these manipulations. I don't want to go through that, so you can automate this and do it all at once instead of two separate interactions for the function call, which may help you if you're running a list of these and iterating through different coins to get the buy sells. So that's where you would want to automate this process. I'm giving you a general layout of how this actually works. Then I decided let's change the index positions because look, all of those were zero. Next, we're going to deal with the ticker and then whatever market, coin, crypto, whatever you want to call, that's what you're pulling. Let's do our third get request, see what we pull. This is pretty simple. So you can run a list of values, run them through here and store them exceptionally easy, and then just avoid this success from your function call for the get request. And this is the information you get if that's all you're interested in. But it's similar to what we had above, if you think about it. We can get historical data, which is also interesting, based on each coin you're interested in. And here's the extension piece that you just add onto your base URL. And then the only thing that you need to pay particular attention is this date time formatting, which you need to do a conversion on. And I can show you how that works. So we roll through, we put this in to the data frame, we import date time, and we're taking this timestamp. And what we're dealing with for here, let's look at this step by step, right? If you do it like this, and you take our first entry from this example for data frame, this is what we deal with. We're dealing with July 17th of 2022, and then with this time, right? And you say, all right, well, I want this a little more manageable. So I want it in this formatting. And of course, if you're in any other country, you would change the date and the time. I mean, the month and day you would switch if you're in another country. And we got the military time here. So this is the string formatting selection that you would take to convert this column right here. This fifth example or fifth DF is just me adding the new column that I appended all the information and changed the date time formatting. And this was a pretty straightforward video for this particular API and some of the formatting for the data that you can use in future analysis. But anyone who wants to start using the Trade Ogre API and do their own market analysis, this would be a good primer to get you started. But I want to say, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. And don't forget, data science, data science, data science, data science, data science, data science, programming, Python, data analyst, technology, 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 algorithm, y'all. Peace.
Hey kid, don't ever let them get inside your head. They'll tell you what to do in life instead of everything you know that you could get.